A Practical Guide to Blood Loss Measurement by OBS Cymru, the Obstetric Bleeding Strategy for Wales. OBS Cymru is a Welsh Government-funded project. It is a collaboration involving all of the health boards within Wales, the 1000 Lives campaign, and the Welsh Maternity Network. The main aim of OBS Cymru is to work together to reduce the harm from postpartum hemorrhage. In order to reduce the harm from postpartum hemorrhage, it is vital that the amount of blood loss by the mother is measured accurately and promptly. This teaching session will guide you through the process of blood loss measurement, which should be used for every delivery. By the end of this teaching session, you should understand the importance of measuring blood loss, be able to measure blood loss more accurately in different birth settings, including a vaginal delivery in a room, and any delivery or case in the theatre setting. Be familiar with the OBS Cymru four-stage approach to postpartum hemorrhage management. Postpartum hemorrhage, or PPH, remains an important cause of maternal death and illness following childbirth worldwide. PPH is the third cause of direct maternal deaths in the UK, and it can transform a healthy woman in labour into a critically ill patient within minutes. PPH is made worse by a failure to recognise the PPH and its severity, as well as a delay in the treatment of it. This means that the amount of blood lost is likely to be greater, which will have a negative effect on the condition of the mother. In order to work together to reduce harm from PPH, the OBS Cymru four pillars of PPH management should be followed. Risk assessment. All women should be risk assessed on admission to the delivery unit. Early identification. It is important to identify a PPH promptly. Blood loss should be measured at each birth to ensure an accurate value of blood loss is calculated in real time. Multidisciplinary team approach. The whole MDT, including midwives, theatre staff, obstetricians and anaesthetists, should take responsibility for the measurement of blood loss. It is important that everyone is actively involved. Rotem-guided blood loss management. A Rotem is now available in each consultant-led delivery unit in Wales. If a woman loses more than 1,000 millilitres of blood, a Rotem blood test should be taken. These results will help guide the decision to use blood products. Measuring blood loss is a vital part in both the early identification of a PPH, as well as ensuring a multidisciplinary team approach is taken. This session will focus on these two aspects. How do we improve the recognition of a postpartum hemorrhage? Perform a risk assessment. The risk of having a PPH should be assessed for all women on admission to the delivery unit. If a woman is identified as being at an increased risk of having a PPH, we should ensure that she is made suitable for the electronic issue of blood, or 2 units of cross-matched blood should be made available. Early identification. This includes the measurement of all blood loss during delivery. Why should blood loss be measured? Local as well as international research has shown that the estimation of blood loss is very inaccurate. This could lead to suboptimal treatment of the mother. Small volumes of blood are overestimated. Overestimation of blood loss can lead to unnecessary treatment, including blood transfusions, that expose women to unnecessary risks. Large volumes of blood loss are underestimated. Underestimation of blood loss can lead to a delay in delivering important, life-saving treatment. Measuring or weighing blood loss is significantly more accurate than estimating blood loss. The error rate of measuring blood loss is 15% compared to 50% for estimating. For example, if you visually estimate a loss of 1,000 millilitres, that woman could have actually lost anywhere between 500 millilitres of blood and 1,500 millilitres of blood. These two amounts of blood loss will have very different effect on a woman's condition, and the treatment of the two amounts are very different. How do we measure blood loss? The basic principle to understand is that 1 gram of weighed blood is equal to 1 milliliter of blood loss. For example, 500 grams of weighed blood is equal to 500 milliliters of blood loss. It is important to account for all types of blood loss to ensure an accurate total blood loss is calculated. Blood can be collected in blood-soaked swabs, pads, drapes, and incontinence sheets, which can hold a deceivingly large amount of blood, in liquid form, for example in kidney dishes, suction canisters, under buttock drapes, or as clots. The dry weight of all swabs, pads, and incontinence sheets needs to be known in order to calculate the amount of blood held within a blood-soaked item. Refer to the OBS Cymru guidance sheet of dry weights for reference. Weigh all blood-soaked items. Then subtract the dry weight of each item. This will leave you with the amount of blood within the items. As 1 gram of weight is equal to 1 milliliter of blood, the amount of blood in the items in grams is equal to the amount of blood within the item in millilitres. If a woman delivers in the delivery room, place a clean incontinence sheet underneath her as soon as the baby has been delivered. Make sure that you include all of the blood loss in your measurement. Weigh your blood-soaked swabs, pads, and incontinence sheets as previously discussed. Measure all liquid blood in kidney dishes, bowls, and under buttock drapes. Weigh all clots. If the delivery takes place in theatre as a caesarean section or instrumental delivery, or the woman is taken to theatre for treatments such as repair of a perineal tear or evacuation of a retained placenta, the same principles apply for measuring blood loss. It is important to remember that all liquid blood in the suction needs to be included, along with the liquid blood in the under buttock drape. All blood clots need to be weighed, along with all blood-soaked swabs, pads, and incontinence sheets. All blood lost and collected in the cell salvage needs to be included in the total. Please refer to the OBS Cymru guidance for the calculation of blood loss in cell salvage. If there was a lot of amniotic fluid present, such as at the time of an elective caesarean section, it is important to note the total amount of amniotic fluid in the suction, prior to any blood that is collected, so that it can be subtracted from the total volume within the container. This will give the amount of blood within the suction container. How often should blood loss be measured? Blood loss should be measured as guided by the OBS Cymru four-stage approach to PPH management. It should be measured and recorded at least every 15 minutes and more frequently if the blood loss is more severe. At 500 millilitres of blood loss, the Band 7 midwife, or most senior midwife, should be informed. At 1,000 millilitres blood loss, the whole MDT should be made aware. As already mentioned, measuring blood loss and the management of postpartum hemorrhage is a responsibility of every member of the MDT, including midwives, theatre staff, obstetricians and anaesthetists. It is essential that we all work together and communicate continually to ensure that we all work together to reduce the harm from postpartum hemorrhage. How do we improve the treatment of PPH? Because the blood loss has been measured accurately by the MDT, any treatment required can be given without delay. As part of OBS Cymru, all consultant-led delivery units should have access to a ROTEM, a point-of-care test for clotting. Any blood product management that is given to a patient should be guided by the ROTEM and the Massive Obstetric Hemorrhage Protocol. This is an overview of the four-stage approach to PPH management. It has been designed to assist the team in assessment of all women regarding their risk factors for PPH and then the management of a PPH. The documentation should be filled in for each patient and will guide the team through the steps that should be covered in each section. At each step, it highlights what should be mobilised, the actions to be taken, and the treatment to be given. In order to work together to reduce the harm from PPH, it is important that all of these elements are covered. Risk assessment, early identification and MDT approach, which includes the importance of blood loss measurement, ROTEM-guided blood treatment. Thank you for taking the time to complete this tutorial. We hope that as a result of this session, you can now appreciate that measuring blood loss is essential in all delivery settings and should be performed accurately and promptly. It is important to ensure that all forms of blood are included in the calculation of the total blood loss from the woman. Following the OBS Cymru approach to postpartum hemorrhage management will guide you through the appropriate steps to take at each stage of blood loss. By following these principles, we will be able to work together to reduce the harm from postpartum hemorrhage. Please watch this short video to summarise this session.
obstetric hemorrhage is the leading cause of maternal morbidity and mortality worldwide, accounting for up to half of all maternal deaths in some countries, and approximately 10% of all direct maternal deaths in the UK. 80% of maternal morbidity is associated with postpartum hemorrhage, and a significant proportion of this is likely to be preventable. It is estimated that postpartum hemorrhage affects about 1 in 7 maternities, and the incidence appears to be increasing both in the UK and internationally. Postpartum hemorrhage causes harm, and is made worse by failure of recognition and delays in treatment. The most accurate way to recognise the amount of blood loss is by direct measurement and cumulative quantification. So how do you quantify blood loss? Weigh blood-soaked items like Inco sheets and swabs. Measure blood using calibrated equipment such as underbuttock drapes and containers. First, let's talk about weighing blood loss. To establish the amount of blood loss, place the blood-soaked item on a scale, subtract the dry weight from the blood-soaked weight to determine the value of blood loss. As a general rule, 1 milliliter of blood weighs approximately 1 gram. For example, if the dry weight of an item is 40 grams, and this item weighs 140 grams when saturated, then 140 grams wet weight minus 40 grams dry weight equals 100 milliliters blood loss. You must make sure to weigh all blood-soaked items, materials, and clots. Now let's talk about measuring blood loss in containers. Measure using graduated or calibrated suction containers and underbuttock drapes with calibrated pouches, remembering to subtract other fluids such as amniotic fluid or urine. For example, if the underbuttock drape has collected 750 milliliters of fluid, subtracting 250 milliliters of wash fluid equals 500 milliliters of blood. It isn't, however, always this straightforward, since it can be hard to know how much urine or amniotic fluid there is in the container. One strategy that can help with precisely measuring accurate blood loss is to document the amount of fluid collected in a container prior to the delivery of the placenta. Since most of the fluid collected prior to the delivery of the placenta isn't blood, but most of the fluid collected after the placenta has been delivered is blood. From here, we need to ensure cumulative blood loss is documented by keeping a running total. Postpartum hemorrhage can transform a healthy woman in labour into a critically ill patient within minutes. We must work together to reduce harm from postpartum hemorrhage. Quantification of blood loss at every birth can help save women's lives. This video has been co-produced by A1, the Association of Women's Health, Obstetric and Neonatal Nurses, promoting the health of women and newborns, and OBS Cymru, the Obstetric Bleeding Strategy for Wales, a quality improvement collaboration. For more information about OBS Cymru, contact us at obs.cymru@wales.nhs.uk. For more information on A1's postpartum hemorrhage project, please visit pphproject.org. To access and download A1's summary of the research on quantification of blood loss, and to access their other support materials, go to www.pphproject.org/resources.asp.